talk a little bit about static. So I need a couple volunteers to come up. Volunteers who do not mind me messing up their hair, because I'm definitely going to mess up your hair if you come on up. So have you come up? These balloons here, our little balloon Puffy is stuck to the wall. Puffy is stuck to the wall because there are extra electrons on the balloon, giving it a bit of a negative charge. But that charge, bit by bit, the electrons will travel into the wall, and eventually they'll all just dissipate. They'll go like into the air, they'll go into the wall, they'll travel other places, and they'll just spread out. And when that happens, then the balloon will just drift down and fall to the ground. And same thing with you. If you go down a slide and you get a real good charge where you can feel like, oh, my clothes feel all staticky, if you just run around and play for a while, eventually, just on its own, the charge will go away. But if you give the charge an opportunity to go away all at once, that's when you feel the shock. We can charge balloons by rubbing balloons onto a fabric. We can also charge plastic. Anything that is an insulator can build up a static charge. So if I rub this plastic pipe, can you guys hear that? Listen.
Yeah.
You hear like a little crackle crackle sound? We're getting a static charge. And now if I lay this metal can on its side, watch and tell me if the can is attracted or repelled by the pipe.
Attracted.
Super attracted to the pipe.
Oh,
it followed it right off. Seems like magic, but it's not magic. It's the science of static electricity.
What?
The future is here.
So I'm going to really rub this to try and give it a lot of charge, and then we're going to drop the tinsel on.
Whoa.
There's a free download linked in the description. You can print this paper and then fold it into a little pocket-sized book, and it goes through each of the activities with instructions for how to do them. Let me show you how to tie the tinsel oars, because they can be just a little bit tricky. First, you need to make sure you have the right type of tinsel, because not all tinsel will work. This newer tinsel that hangs really straight and pretty looks about the same as the old style tinsel that's a little more flimsy, but it's slightly heavier, and it's too heavy to float. No matter how much static you have, this orbs from this type of tinsel will never work. So Bright Star Tinsel is the brand that I use that reliably works very well. I found a few other cheap tinsel brands that work too. And check the link in the description, because from time to time I do giveaways through my Patreon page where I mail out little orbs of tinsel that are pre-tied, so I might be doing one of those. All right. You want 6 strands, and you're going to tie a knot, just a simple overhand knot like you do to start tying your shoe. And then you want to go down about maybe a hand width down, five inches or so, loop around, and tie your second knot. So that's a good length for a tinsel orb. Now, if you tie your knots carefully, you'll be able to make 2 orbs out of 1 set of strands. So you want to tie another knot, and then go down and tie your last knot, and then you're just going to trim off the excess tinsel. Now, these can be tricky, especially at the beginning. Don't worry if your first few strands you end up not being able to use them because the knots don't work out. Just keep practicing and you will get it. So here is 1 tinsel orb, and just trim off the ends there. And there's our second tinsel orb. If you don't have a length of PVC pipe, you can do this with a balloon. It can be a little bit trickier to get the balloon charged, and I will say if it's raining outside, then this won't work at all, not with a balloon or a pipe, because it's too humid and you won't be able to get enough static electricity to make it work. The key to this is that you want so many excess electrons on the pipe or the balloon that as soon as the tinsel orb touches it, some of those electrons will be transferred to the tinsel orb enough that they both are charged negatively and they repel each other.
Sometimes when you drop your tinsel onto the pipe, it might puff up but not bounce off. If you just give it a little shake, then you can get it to float.
And usually you want to recharge your pipe in between each time doing the levitating orb. And I want to give a quick shout out to Science Bob, because I believe that he's the one that first invented this levitating orb. You can find more about it at his website, which I'll link in the description. And this is, hands down, my very favorite static electricity demonstration.
Oh man!
Stuck right to it.
Try again.
Yeah, see? Fantastic.